Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2106. Create a PDF of every combination of three slicers. What a great question we have today. Someone wrote in, wanted to know if it was possible. Right now, they have three slicers running a pivot table. I don't know what the pivot table looks like. It's confidential. I'm not allowed to see it. So I'm just guessing, right? So what they're doing is they're choosing one item from each slicer and then creating a PDF and then going and choosing the next item and creating a PDF and then the next item and the next item. And you can imagine, with 400 combinations of slicers, this could take forever. And they said, is there some way to have a program go through and loop through all the options? And I said, all right, here's some qualifying questions. Number one, we're not on a Mac, right? Not Android, not Excel for the iPhone. This is Excel for Windows. Yes, they said, great. I said, second really important question is we want to choose one item from a slicer, and then eventually the other item from the slicer, and then the other item from the slicer. We don't need combinations like Andy, and then Andy and Betty, and then Andy and Charlie, right? That's out. I'm just going to do one item from each slicer. Yes, 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 that's the way it's going to go. Perfect, I said. All right, so here, tell me this. Choose each slicer, go to the slicer tools options, and go to slicer settings. We just did this two episodes ago. Isn't this crazy? Named using formulas. And I know that it's slicer underscore reviewer, slicer underscore antenna, slicer underscore discipline. All right. So I think I've got it. Now we're going to switch over to VBA here. By the way, make sure that you're saved as XLSM and make sure your macro security is set to allow macros. If it's saved as XLSX, trust me, you have to go do a file save as. You're going to lose all your work if you leave it as XLSX. Yes, 99.9% of the spreadsheets that you use are XLSX, but this one with a macro will not work. Alt F11. All right, so here's the code. We're going to define three slicer caches, one slicer item, and three ranges. For each of the slicer caches, we're going to set it to the name used in formula that I just showed you in the slicer settings dialog box. So we have the three of those. We're going to clear all those to make sure that we're back to everything being selected. This counter is going to be used in the file name later. All right, now this next section here, off to the right, build three static lists of all slicer items. See outtake number two to see why this craziness had to happen. So I'm going to figure out where the next available column is, kind of go over two from the last column. Remember that so I can delete the stuff later. And then for each SI slicer item in sc1.slicerItems, we're going to write that slicer caption to the spreadsheet. When we're done with all of those slicer items, figure out how many rows we had today, and then name that range as slicer items 1. We're going to repeat that whole thing for slicer cache 2, going over one column, slicer items 2, and slicer items 3. Let me show you what it looks like at this point. So I'll put a breakpoint right here, and we will run this code. All right, that was fast. We're going to switch over to VBA. And far off here to the right-hand side, I'm going to get three new lists. These lists are everything that's in the slicer, and you see it's called slicer items 1, slicer items 2, and slicer items 3. All right, we will get rid of that at the end, but that gives us something to loop through. Back to VBA. All right, we're going to loop through all the items in slicer items 1, clear the filter for slicer cache 1, and then we're going to go through one at a time through each slicer item and see if this slicer item is equal to the cell 1 dot value. And again, we're looping through each of the values. So the first time through, it's going to be Andy and then Betty and you know, and so on. It's frustrating. I couldn't find any way to turn all the slicers off at once. I even tried recording the code and choosing one slicer, and the recorded code was we're turning 9 slicers off and turning the one slicer on. All right? Frustrating that I couldn't find anything better than that, but I couldn't find anything better than that. So we set the first slicer equal to Andy, then we go through, and for the second slicer, we're going to set it equal to the first item. For the third slicer, set it equal to the first item. All right, then down here, decide if this is a valid combination. I got to explain to you why that's important. If we, as humans, were doing this, Andy, we would not choose A52 because clearly it's grayed out. But the macro is going to be too stupid, and it's going to choose A52 and then 104, and it's going to create this empty pivot table. So there's 1,000 possible combinations here. I know that there's only 400 possible reports. That's what the person told me. And so we're going to get 600 times where we're going to create a PDF of this ugly report. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look here on the Analyze tab. It was called Options in 2010, and see what the name of this pivot table is. And I want to see how many rows we get. Now, in my case, if I get 2 rows, I know it's a report I don't want to export. If I get more than 2 rows, 3, 4, 5, 6, then I know it is a report that I do want to export. You're going to have to figure out in your situation which it is. All right, so that's why we're checking to see if the pivot table 2, and that's the name on that was back there in the ribbon, .table_range2.rows.count is greater than 2. If it's not greater than 2, we don't want to create a PDF. All right, so this if statement down to this end if is saying we're only going to create the PDFs for the report combinations that have values. My file name, I created a folder called C:reports, just an empty folder, C:reports. You make sure that you have a folder and use the same folder name in the macro. C:reports/, and the name of the file is going to be report001.pdf. Now counter, we initialize back up there as 1. I'm using format, which is equivalent in Excel to saying the text of counter, 000. That way, I'm going to get 001, then 002, then 003, and then 004. They're going to sort correctly. If I had just called this report 1, and then later on I have a report 10 and 11, and later on report 100, those are all going to sort together when they don't belong together. All right, so creating the name of the file. In case the file exists from the last time we ran this, we're going to kill it, in other words, delete it. Of course, if you try and kill a file that's not there, they will throw an error. So if we get an error in the next line, that's fine, just go on. But then I reset the error checking on error, go to 0. Here's the ActiveSheet export as fixed format as a PDF. There's the file name, all those choices. And then I increment the counter, so that way next time we find one that has records, we'll be creating report002.pdf. Finish those three loops and then clear out the static list. So remember which column we were, resize one row, three columns, entire column.clear, and then a nice little message box there to show that things have been created. Okay, let's run it. All right, now what should be happening here is if we go and look in Windows Explorer, there it is. Look at it. It's creating like every second we're getting 2 or 3 or 4 or more. I'll pause this and let it run. All right, there we are. 326 reports have been created. It looped through all 1,000 possibilities and only kept the ones where there was an actual result. All right, from 9:38 until 9:42, 4 minutes to do all that, but still faster than doing the 400, right? All right, so that's the macro way to do this. The other thing that struck me here that may or may not work, it's really tough to say. Let's take our data, and I'm going to move the data to a brand new workbook. Move or copy, create a copy to a new book, click OK. And we're going to use a trick here that I first learned from Szilvia Juhasz, a great Excel consultant out in Southern California. And we're going to add a key field here. The key field is equal. Reviewer, ampersand, antenna, ampersand, discipline. We'll copy that down. And we'll insert a new pivot table. Click OK. And we're going to take that field, the key field, and move it up to the old fashioned filters. And then let's see, let's just build a little report here. Reviewer, antenna, discipline, and revenue, like that. All right, now normally what we would do here is we'd come open this filter and choose one item from the filter. But the trick from Szilvia is that we can take this pivot table and go to either the Analyze tab in 13 or 16 or the Options tab in 2010. Open the Options drop down, say Show Report Filter Pages, show all pages of key. And what it's doing right now is it's inserting a new worksheet for every unique combination of the key, probably 300 in some files. All right. Now, how many worksheets can you have in a workbook? Well, that number is different on every computer, and it depends on how complicated the workbook is because it's limited by available memory. But here we start on AndyB37112. I'm going to press Control and this arrow down to Joe. Like that. The beautiful advantage here is when I do File, Export, Create a PDF, and then All Reports, we're going to end up with a single PDF with all 326 reports in it. Now, we could have created a single PDF using Adobe Acrobat, select all of these reports, right-click, and combine files in Acrobat, but that requires you to have a full version of Acrobat, not just Acrobat Reader. So this great trick using show report filtered pages from Szilvia might be a great alternative if you have enough memory to create all the versions. All right, to learn more about VBA, check out this book, Excel 2016 VBA and Macros by Bill Jelen and Tracy Seerstad. I'll get you up the VBA learning curve. All right, the goal is to loop through all combinations in three slicers and generate a PDF for each. Use the little VBA to loop through the slicers, save as PDF using VBA. The alternate solution there at the end is Szilvia Juhasz's show report filter pages, and then export the whole thing as a PDF. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Well, this will be an outtake. First time I ran this darn thing, I got 1,000 of them, and every darn one of them was Andy A52104. I'm like, what the heck is going on? Except I didn't say heck. All right, so here, watch this code. This was the code I had. I said, I'm going to go through all of the filters for each SI and SE.1 slicer items. I set it equal to false, and then the one that I want, I'll set equal to true, right? Sounded like a great bit of code, right? So here's what happens. The first one is Andy, goes away. Betty, goes away. Charlie, goes away. Dale, here, I'll just keep pressing F8, F8, F8. F8, I'm down to the last one. This is Joe. I'm about to set Joe equal to false, and watch what happens over there in Excel. Bam! Once you turn Joe off, it turns them all back on. I mean, that stinks, Excel. And then I would try and turn, Andy back on, and turning Andy back on when everybody else is already on. So it ran through, it created 1,000 of the PDFs. And every stinking one, it was Andy A52104. It's funny now. It wasn't then. All right, here's another outtake. Why did I go to the trouble of building the list, the static list, off to the right-hand side so I can loop through that static list? Well, originally, I was looping through all of the items in the slicers themselves, and it was causing some wrong results. See here, Andy A52112 should be 0. But when I actually ran the loop, Andy A52112 is showing up with 6 rows. I'm like, well, that can't be. So over here in my code, Alt F11, I put a thing, if SI1.caption equals Andy, SI2.caption equals A52, SI3.caption equals 112, then stop, right? So let's run this code. Then stop. There we are. And I will come back. We should have Andy A52112, but when I look, Andy, it's not A52, it's D33. What the heck is going on? And then I come back here, Alt F11, and I right click and say that I want to add a watch. And when I look at this, it claims that the caption is A52. But very clearly, it's D33. So, is this a bug, or am I just violating some weird rule by looping through a collection of 10 items when the order of those 10 items is constantly being reordered? It seems like that must be the problem. Hence, we went with the static list off to the right. And the third outtake. All right, this is the one that's crazy. If I want to record a macro, if I want to write a macro to choose just one item, figure out how to do that by using developer, record macro, how to choose one item from slicer, click OK, and we simply choose one item, flow, click stop recording, and we go Alt F8, how to choose one item from slicer, edit that, and sure enough, they make flow true and then everybody else false. That means if I had a slicer with 100 items in it, they would have to put 100 lines of code in there to unselect everything else. Seems incredibly inefficient, but there you are.